Hello, my name is CC, and welcome to Old School RuneScape Tips and Tricks of 2020. Before the video, consider subscribing to my channel if you like the content, and of course, thank you. Tip 1. Bank eating. Since 9th of the January 2020, you can now eat food, drink potions or any other liquids you fancy, and equip items from your inventory while the bank or deposit box interfaces are open. You can toggle this option on and off via the bank setting panel, which will also change the option for deposit boxes. Tip 2. Graceful outfit. As your first items, buy top and legs. Previously, run energy restored 30% faster while wearing all 6 pieces of the graceful outfit. Now the hood, cape, gloves and boots give an individual 3% boost, and the top and legs give 4% each. This adds up to 20% run energy bonus with an additional 10% bonus for wearing the whole outfit, which matches the previous 30% boost. Tip 3. RuneScape Wiki. Right-clicking or long-pressing the Wiki icon brings up Lookup Entity and Search options. Lookup Entity allows you to click, tap on any entity in the game world or your inventory worn items, and automatically open the relevant Wiki page in your web browser. Right-clicking, long-pressing on a quest or achievement diary will now give you the option to open a Wiki guide. Search allows you to enter a term in the chat box and search the Wiki for any relevant pages. You can also search by typing Wiki, search term in the chat box. Tip 4. Bags, sacks and spice racks. Okay, that rhymed a little bit. Open and close options have been added. While open, suitable items will be added to the vessels automatically on pickup. Such as seed box, works on any seeds picked up from the ground. Herb sack, works on any grimy herbs picked up from the ground, harvested from herb patches and harvested from herbivores. Coal bag, works on any coal mined from rocks. Gem bag, works on any gems obtained while mining or pickpocketing Thuhazar creatures. You can also build a spice rack in the kitchen of your POH. This requires 60 construction, 3 thick planks, 6 soft clay and 4 doses of each color of spice. The rack itself can store 2 billion doses of each spice. Jagex hopes that that's enough. I hope so. Tip 5. Ultra Compost is the most potent version of compost, outclassing Super Compost, that is used in the farming skill to greatly reduce the chance of farming patch from becoming diseased per growth stage by 90%, compared to 50% for compost and 85% for super compost. When used on a farming patch, each bucket grants 36 farming experience. The minimum number of herb increases from 5 to 6 when compared to super compost. And overall, the crop yield is around 20% higher on average. The combined effects increase expected yield per patch to about 8.6 herbs at high farming levels. As a rule of thumb, Ultra Compost should only be used on farming patches that can produce a valuable harvest, such as high-level herbs and silicious bark, and or provide significant experience for each item harvested, such as watermelons. Ultra Compost does not increase the yield of trees, fruit trees or bush patches, therefore it is not recommended to treat those patches with Ultra Compost if you plan to pay a gardener to watch over them, since there is no benefit other than extra 36 experience granted. Tip 6. Notifications. Great tool for loot drop notification. Insert 1GP and you will see every drop you get from any NPC. You can always change the amount you want to set as a drop, but my recommendation is to keep at 1 because it is cool to see what you get. Tip 7. Summer pies. Summer pies are eaten in 2 halves. Each half gives 11 hit points, boosts agility temporarily by 5 levels and restores 10% energy. Each whole pie therefore restores up to 22 hit points and gives 20% run energy. After eating the summer pie, a pie dish will remain, but I don't really know if you will use it or not, it's worthless, I would just drop it. Summer pies can be great food for training agility due to their high hit points restoration and agility level boost. For example, at the Brimhaven Agility Arena, there are dart obstacles that temporarily lower a player's agility level by 2 if failed. Eating a slice of the pie will restore some of the player's agility level without having to wait for it to return to normal. Summer pies are also very useful when fighting the Havas elemental, since players are able to eat them very quickly and leave behind pie dishes, preventing the elemental from unequipping their armor. This is also useful during quests which require a high agility levels, such as Regicide and the Underground Pass. Tip 8. Winter Todd items. If you play Winter Todd minigame, you have a great option for the same items you receive throughout this minigame. If you already have 3 parts of worn gloves and it is successfully rolled, a magic seed is given. If the player already has 3 Bruma torches and it is successfully rolled, a Thorstal seed is given. That is really cool that Jagex added this update, really nice. Tip 9. Bank PIN. Bank PIN, short form for Personal Identification Number, is a security feature that players can use to protect their banks. It was introduced in the Bank PIN update on 19 September 2005. To get a bank PIN, you may talk to a banker and say that they would like to check their PIN settings. Once they have done this, they may then set a 4-digit PIN. The bank PIN may be cancelled before it is put to use. Their bank will then have a bank PIN in 7 days. Bank PINs are a form of damage control against account thieves. Accounts can be stolen if an attacker obtains the login name and the password, of course. If a computer is infected with a keylogger, it is possible for a thief to learn the login name and password combinations. Even without such malware infections, weak passwords might be guessed. If an account thief is armed with only a username and a password, they will not be able to access the item stored away in the account's bank. Additionally, a keylogger cannot easily obtain the PIN because players have to click on the numbers instead of typing them. Bank PINs are the best things players can have to protect their bank account, and it is strongly recommended to have one. In addition, players are well advised to only access their accounts from a trusted and non-infected computer. A non-obvious password and periodic password changes also help to prevent unauthorized access to accounts. The bank PIN system also appears when attempting to enter the player-owned house in building mode for the first time after logging in into the game. This helps protect the player-owned house from vandalism and/or theft from the costume room. After 2 failed attempts to enter the bank PIN, the system locks the player out for 10 seconds and tells him or her to use the cancel option if he or she has made a mistake in entering their PIN code. After another failed attempt, system locks the player out for 15 seconds. Once 4 failed attempts are made, the player must wait 10 minutes before trying again. Tip 10. Entering bank when relogging. As of 9th March 2017, players can now choose whatever bank PINs should stay unlocked for 5 minutes after logging out by speaking to a banker and opening the PIN settings menu. This would allow players to hop worlds or take quick bathroom breaks without having to re-enter the bank PIN when logging back in. However, if players appear to be logging in from a different IP address or computer, the bank PIN will always be relocked itself immediately. Tip 11. Free for all portal. The Free for All portal is a white portal found in the Clan Wars area in Alcarid as well. It can teleport players to the Free for All area of the Clan Wars minigame. This portal is often used by players during quests, slayer tasks, and of course bossing. It will fully restore a player's health, stats, prayer, and cures poison and venom upon entering and leaving. Players can leave via teleportation through the exit portal or death. The same stay regeneration effect will occur with all 3 methods. Tip 12. Agility level influence. A higher agility level allows for faster run energy restoration. At level 1 agility, a player recovers 1% of their run energy every 7.5 seconds. At level 50 agility, a player recovers the same amount in only 4 seconds. So by getting only level 30 agility in old school RuneScape will grant you 33% faster run energy regeneration, which is really awesome, and 30 agility isn't that hard to get. Tip 13, ZMI running. The best way to get to an Ulta is to use your pure essence on another running player, and you won't be stuck or lose your path. If you follow the player, you might get stuck if you get too close to him or get stuck by crevices. So just use your pure essence on the running player. If the player stops for no reason, it is common, by the way, just use your essence on a different person until you will get to the altar you need. Tip 14, rejuvenation pool. Best option in game is to use the rejuvenation pool after bossing, PvP and other activities where you might get poisoned, energy drained, etc. To get rejuvenation pool, you will need at least 82 construction with the help of boosts, of course, spicy stews and crystal saw. This is how I got mine, because I just don't want to waste money on construction, because it is kinda useful skill after 82. I just need that rejuvenation pool. After the fight or whatever you do, just teleport to your house and use the rejuvenation pool, easy as that. Another good thing is to have a teleport like jewelry box, portals for faster banking. I hope you enjoyed this video in Old School RuneScape tips and tricks. If you didn't enjoy it, consider subscribing for future uploads, leave a comment if you have any questions, and as always, have a nice day, guys!